Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. I am Dr. Deepthi and in this video, I am going to talk about the human excretory system. So let's get it started.
Excretion is the process in which the metabolic wastes are eliminated from the body of an organism. Many nitrogen-containing substances, carbon dioxide, certain ions, water, etc. are harmful if they accumulate in the body and therefore they have to be eliminated. Ammonia, urea and uric acid are the major nitrogenous wastes which are harmful for the body of organisms and therefore they are excreted out. Organisms that excrete ammonia are called ammonotelic. For example, many bony fishes, aquatic amphibians and aquatic insects are ammonotelic organisms. Whereas reptiles, birds, insects and land snails excrete uric acid and are called uricotelic animals. While mammals, marine fishes and many terrestrial amphibians excrete urea and are called ureotelic animals. Major excretory product in human beings is urea, which is excreted in urine. Ammonia produced by metabolism is converted into urea in the liver and released into the blood, which is filtered by the kidneys. Other than the kidneys, lungs, liver and skin also help in waste removal. The excretory system of human beings consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, a urinary bladder and a urethra. Kidneys are reddish brown, bean-shaped. They lie on the left and right side in the retroperitoneal space behind the abdomen. The right kidney is slightly smaller and lower than the left. Each kidney of an adult human is 10 to 12 cm in length, 5 to 7 cm in width, 2 to 3 cm in thickness and have an average weight of 120 to 170 grams. Inside the kidneys, two zones are present, an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The medulla divides into conical masses called medullary pyramids projecting into calyces. A notch called hilum is present towards the center of inner concave surface of the kidney through which ureter, blood vessels and nerves enter. Inner to the hilum, funnel-shaped renal pelvis is present. The primary function of the kidney is to make urine by the ultrafiltration of the blood. Each kidney filters blood and toxic substances like creatinine, urea, etc. are excreted in the urine. It helps in the regulation of fluid balance by excreting excess amount of water through urine. Our kidneys maintain homeostasis. It plays an important role in the regulation of certain mineral ions and chemicals such as sodium, potassium, calcium, phosphorus, bicarbonates, etc. and thus maintains the composition of the body fluids. This is known as osmoregulation. Kidneys are responsible for the production of hormones like renin, angiotensin, aldosterone, etc., which help to regulate water and salt concentration in the body and thus play a vital role in maintaining blood pressure. Each kidney contains about 1 million nephrons, which are the structural and functional units of the kidneys. They constitute Bowman's capsule, glomerulus, arterioles, proximal collecting tubule, U-shaped Henle's loop, distal collecting tubule, and collecting duct. The glomerulus is a tuft of capillaries present inside a cup-shaped structure called Bowman's capsule. The process of urine formation involves three main processes known as glomerular filtration, selective reabsorption, and tubular secretion. The filtration of blood is the first step in urine formation, which is carried out by the glomerulus. The kidneys filter about 1100 to 1200 ml of blood per minute. The amount of filtrate found by the kidney per minute is called glomerular filtration rate or GFR. GFR is about 125 ml per minute, that is about 180 liters per day in a healthy person. The blood enters the glomerulus via the afferent arteriole and leaves it via the efferent arteriole. Water and solutes smaller than proteins are forced through the capillary walls and pores of the glomerular capsule into the tubule, and in this way, glomerular filtration takes place. Proximal collecting tubule is the major site of reabsorption and selective secretion. tubular reabsorption is the process in which water, glucose, amino acids, and necessary ions are removed out of the filtrate into the tubule cells and sent to the blood. And this loop maintains osmolar gradient within the kidney. The filtrate gets concentrated in the descending limb and gets diluted by the ascending limb. The distal convoluted tubule and collecting tubule play important role in the reabsorption of water and certain electrolytes, which help in osmoregulation. The secretion of hydrogen ion, potassium ion, and ammonia into the filtrate help in maintaining the ionic balance and pH of the body fluids. The filtrate gets concentrated about 4 times by the distal tubule and collecting tubule by the mechanism of conservation of water. Urine is passed into the urinary bladder through the ureters and stored till a voluntary signal initiated by the stretching of urinary bladder is given by the CNS. The urine is released through the urethra and the process is called micturition. Disorders of the excretory system. Uremia is the condition in which the dysfunctioning of the kidney can lead to the accumulation of urea in the blood, which may cause kidney failure. Renal calculi, also known as kidney stones, is the condition in which insoluble mass of crystallized salts, such as oxalates, etc., forms within the kidney, which gives rise to severe pain in the patient. Urinary tract infection, or UTI, is caused by microorganisms. If hygiene is not maintained, it affects the urinary system, which can be severe if not treated. The glomerulonephritis is the inflammation of the glomeruli of the kidney, which affect the process of blood filtration. Renal failure is the condition in which there is a decrease or cessation of glomerular filtration occurs in human. In acute renal failure, the kidneys abruptly stop working. In chronic renal failure, a gradual loss of kidney function occurs. Edema is the accumulation of excess fluid in the tissues, which is usually caused by an excess of sodium ion, which causes retention. Some of the disorders of the excretory system can be cured by medicines, but when both the kidneys fail to function, the blood of the patient is filtered by the help of artificial kidney or hemodialyzer, and the process is known as hemodialysis. Kidney transplantation is the ultimate method of treatment, which is a surgical procedure. A healthy kidney from a donor is transplanted into the body of the patient.